Hello students, welcome back to another learning session on spreadsheet. Today we are going to learn about how to work with formulae. In this lesson, you will learn about what a formula is, use of mathematical operators, understanding cell references, creating simple formulae. There will also be a demonstration on how to create formulae. You will also perform some quick tests followed by a recap. Let's start with what a formula is. A formula is an expression which calculates the value of a cell. All formulae in Excel must begin with an equal sign. This is because the cell contains or is equal to the formulae and the value it calculates. For example, cell A3 contains a formula which adds the value of cell A2 to the value of cell A1. Excel uses standard operators for formulae, such as a plus sign for addition, a minus sign for subtraction, an asterisk for multiplication, and a forward slash for division. Before we start to create formulae, I would like to show to you a few of the important keys on the keyboard. Those keys are the equal and plus key, the subtraction key, the multiply key, and the divide key. Over on the right, there is the number keypad, and you will find the division symbol, multiply symbol, subtract symbol, and addition symbol. Bear in mind that with the multiply symbol and the plus symbol on the main keyboard, you need to use the shift key to get those characters. Observe the values in cells A1 in both worksheets. As you can see, both are different. In the first worksheet, the formula starts with the equal sign. Therefore, cell A1 shows 8 as the result. The same formula is entered in the second worksheet, but this time without an equal sign. Now you can see that 6 plus 2 appears as the result. Here no calculation has been done as the equal sign is missing at the start. Cell references in Excel are very important. They are used to identify the location of a cell in a worksheet. Most of the time you will use cell references to create a formula. By combining a mathematical operator with cell references, you can create a variety of simple formulae in Excel. Formulae can also include a combination of cell references and numbers, as in the examples shown. The formula in cell A3 adds the values of cells A1 and A2 by making cell references. When you press enter, the formula calculates and displays the answer in cell A3. If the values in the referenced cells change, the formula automatically recalculates. Like in this example, if the value in cell A1 changes to 6, then the value in cell A3 is automatically updated to 8. You can create simple formulae in Excel. In our first example, we are going to use addition. Here we have to calculate the total sales made during 5 days. Sales values in cells B4, B5, B6, B7, and B8 are added together. The result is then displayed in cell B9. The formula used here is equal to B4 plus B5 plus B6 plus B7 plus B8. Let us have a look at another example, this time using subtraction. In this example, we have to calculate the remaining balance. The expenditure value, which is in cell E5, is subtracted from the income value in cell E4. The result appears in cell E6. The formula used here to calculate the remaining balance is equal to E4 minus E5. In our next example, we will use multiplication to calculate the total cost of 10 tables. The quantity of tables in cell H4 is multiplied with price per table in cell H5. The result appears in cell H6. The formula used here to calculate the total cost is equal to H4 multiplied by H5. For our last example, we will use division to calculate the amount received by each winner for a lottery. This is done by dividing the prize money in cell K4 by the number of winners in cell K5. The result appears in cell K6. The formula used here is equal to K4 divided by K5. Dear students, now you're going to see a demonstration on how to create simple formulae using cell references. Our first example is an addition. Here we have sales incurred during 5 days and we are going to calculate the total. So we click in cell B9. Press the equal key to begin the calculation. Then click on the first item, which is in cell B4. Press the plus key. Click on the second item in cell B5. Press the plus key again. Click in cell B6. Press the plus key. Click in cell B7. Press the plus key. And click on the last value in cell B8. Then click on the little tick there and we get the result 1270. Now the nice thing about Excel is automatic calculation. If we change the value in cell B4 to 300, then you will see the result automatically updates to 1370. Okay, so moving along to subtraction, again, click on the cell where the result needs to go. This time we have a calculation that takes expenditure from income. So we select equal from the keyboard. Click on income, minus on the keyboard. Click on the expenditure value. This time just press the enter key and you can see the result there. Let us move back to cell E6. Remember, you can always check in the formula bar to see the actual calculation behind the result. So moving along to the multiplication example. To begin, press the equal key. Click on the quantity in this case. Press the multiply key on the keyboard. Click on the price per table and press the enter key. Now we get 6000 as the result. Come on to the final example, and this is a division calculation. So again, click on the cell where we want the result to appear in. Press equal key on the keyboard. Click on the price money value in this case. Divide on the keyboard. Click on the number of winners, in this case 10. Press the enter key. We see that each person will be receiving 1000 rupees. Now let us do a quick test to evaluate what you have learned today. Read and answer the following questions. You will have about 3 seconds to give your answer. Question number 1. A is an expression which calculates the value of a cell. A. Number. B. Letter. C. Formula. The answer is formula. A formula is an expression which calculates the value of a cell. Question number 2. All formulae in Excel must begin with quotation marks. Is it true or false? The answer is false, as all formulae in Excel must start with an equal sign. Question number 3. Which of the following is not a mathematical operator? A. Plus symbol. B. Asterisk symbol. C. Ampersand symbol. The answer is C. The ampersand symbol is not a mathematical operator. Question number 4. Both cells A1 and A2 will finally display the value 9. Is it true or false? The answer is false, as cell A1 will display 4 plus 5 as there is no equal sign, hence it is not a formula. Question number 5. Which of the following keyboard shortcuts can be used to select the multiply operator? A. Using the shift key. B. Using control key. Or C. Using alt key. The answer is A. The shift key is used to get the multiply symbol on the main keyboard. Question number 6. When you change a value in a cell, the result is updated automatically. Is it true or false? The answer is true, as Microsoft Excel allows for automatic calculation. Well, this is the end of our quick test. I hope that you have been able to find all the correct answers. Now it's time to recap today's lesson. Today we have learned that a formula is an expression which calculates the value of a cell. All formulae in Excel must start with an equal sign. Excel uses mathematical operators for formulae, such as a plus sign for addition, a minus sign for subtraction, an asterisk for multiplication, and a forward slash for division. Then we also had a look on how to get these operators on the keyboard. Then we have also seen how to combine a mathematical operator with cell references. There was also a demonstration on how to create simple formulae. Dear students, thank you for your attention. I hope that you have enjoyed today's lesson. Goodbye and see you soon for another lesson on spreadsheet.